Hey, shalom, 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 man. What's good with y'all boys, bro? I want to give all praises to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh. There was only begotten Son, Yahweh Shah, man. Shalom to the Shawdies, man, aka the virtuous women in the faith, or the repenting women in the faith. And peace and blessings and love to the believing Gentiles. So, I wanted to bring this lesson out yesterday. And as we, first and foremost, you put Yahweh while Yahweh Shah first. You put the Lord and Savior first. And for my brothers who you probably, you desire a woman or an Asha, right? The scriptures, the Lord, he already told us how to move. And I want to do this video for encouragement, but also speaking from experience. And just vibing out, bro. And listen, the Pretty Ricky songs y'all beloved is hearing, bro. Just remember Hebrews 13:4, bro. The bed is undefiled. So always, if you somehow thinking about some perverseness, man, you need to reevaluate your brain, beloved. But meditate on that righteous love. But look, let's get into it, man. It's 5 a.m. Beloved fell asleep at 9. I was tired, but I'm going to get Proverbs 18:22. It says, "Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing, man, and obtaineth the favor of the Lord," bro. All right. So, when you go into the blue letter, man, the scriptures say you gotta find her, man. Alright, but let's go deeper into that, because really, you also gotta remember Yahweh, bro. He said that basically, he guides your steps, man. Alright, so when you find a wife, the Hebrew for that word is Masa or Massa. Right, I know Massa means oppressor, but Masa means to find, to obtain, to secure, to acquire, man, a thing sought, bro. Alright, so when you're looking for a rib or a shawty, alright, you gotta go secure her, man. You gotta acquire her, man. You gotta, one of the definitions says to detect, man. When you find something, you don't just sit there on the sideline and look at it. No, you got to search through the rubble. You got to search through the damn dirt, man. Look, when you're looking for treasure, man, you got to look for the X on the spot. You got to find the X, man. And what that means, you got to go treasure hunting, man. All right? And along the way, from my experience, bro, dude, you're going to have so many... It says, man, trying to become your shawty, bro. And it ain't, listen, it ain't nothing wrong with it if it's lawful. All right. But you what? You rely on the Holy Spirit to show you, man, who is what. But yeah, when you find something, it says to arrive, you come, man, to be able. It says powerful, man. All right. So let's get that Exodus 22:16 as usual, man. All right. Listen, and if a man entice a maid that is not betrothed, man, so she not married to nobody, biblically, put it like that, and lie with her, you having sex with her, you know what I'm saying? He shall surely endow her to be his wife, man, right? So you tell her, look, you my wifey. If her father utterly refuse to give her unto him, he shall pay money according to the dowry of virgins. So I want to get that word entice. Matter of fact, I wonder what entice means in English too. Cause what y'all beloveds gotta understand, just like the other day, man, it was, bro. When I say I'm a mamacita, bro, you gotta be like one of them brown ones. Listen, your spirit will let you know when it's the right time to approach a weaker vessel, man. Like seriously, you can just give her a compliment. Like, bro, you don't even gotta do much. Obviously, use your common sense, beloveds. You know, yes, you're a servant of Hamashiach, but you know, you're also the prince of the power too. All right. And statistically speaking, y'all can Google this. The Israelite man, at least sexually, is the most sought after, man. Okay? So all races of women know this already. So automatically, you so-called in the game. Well, I'm not in the game, but you're already at an advantage, man. Which is why it's imperative if you want a wife to what, take care of yourself. I'm not saying you got to be Trey Songz or Chris Brown, man, or have six figures, but you got to come presentable, man. And it's a beautiful thing. You can't be acting like a druggie and a weirdo. And my whole thing is, if you're like that, bro, you're gonna attract women like that, man. You're not gonna get the type of women you see on the screen, bro, unless they a low vibe. But entice means to attract or tempt by offering pleasure or advantage, man. See, but like, hey girl, look, I got some guavas on me, and you look amazing today. But you don't leave with your pockets. I'm just giving y'all an example. Like, look, you could be attracting her by your intellect, by your wisdom. You know what I mean? A woman, especially, bro, if you're not mentally interested, man, like, you're not gonna allure her. It says to allure her, man, to convince, to persuade, man, to appeal to. You're not gonna be able to persuade every Asha. Every Asha you come across, man. All right, that's why, you know, sometimes you just gotta be yourself. No, all the time be yourself. But in the English, it says to fetch, inviting. You're glamorous, seductive, enchanting, man. So I want to get the blue letter, right? Because a lot of times, man, beloveds, you got to understand, I'm introverted, but I can talk your head off. And you got to know how to have a conversation. Because really, you will know if a beloved is even worthy to be a wifey if she can hold a conversation, man. All right, another tip, man, be genuine. Because, bro, if you're genuine and transparent, this woman can't say, well, I thought he was this way, and et cetera, et cetera. That's why, for me personally, I hate when a woman assumes shit about me. Like, bro, I've either had women tell me I'm very, very, very sexually attractive, or they'll say, like, I'm not a player, but I'm an honorable man. But in the Hebrew, man, it says to deceive, persuade, to flatter, man. Silly, man. Right? You got to have a sense of humor, man. Women don't like, and I'm speaking about righteous women. Righteous women don't like dudes with no damn humor, man. And every woman not going to find you funny either. See what I'm saying? And sometimes, bro, a lot of times it's going to take time for her to get to know you, bro. One of my ox, bro, he called me, bro, after like 2 or 3 years, but he called me, man. And he was telling me, he was like, yeah, bro, you gotta break them down. Like, they have to constantly see you. You know what I mean? It may not work just the first time, man. Why you think beloveds? Why you think they be trying to get your number or whatever, man, and whatever? All right, cause they're trying to see who you are, man, and vice versa. Now, obviously, if you a sheep, man, the Lord gonna give you discernment, so you shouldn't have to worry about, oh, she tricking me, or if she has 10 other side dudes, man. First of all, you shouldn't even be in the rotation. You are the prince of the power. You separate yourself, and that itself is not deep. But to entice also means to be open-minded, man. You gotta know how to listen, man. Sometimes you dudes be getting tricked, bro, because you don't know how to listen. A shawty, man, she'll tell you who she is, man. You just gotta listen, bro. All right, to be simple, man. To be naive, you're like, you're childlike, you're innocent. A lot of dudes, a lot of you Akim, in the new covenant, bro, you think you gotta be a military brickhead, bro. That only works on scallywags and military brickheads, man, with no damn seasoning. And even their women be trying to be feminine, man. I be sitting, bro, I be at the gym, bro. They be surrounding the beloved, man, trying to, you know, be all feminine and shit. I ain't gonna care, bro. The military is like the worst. Bro, it's the worst place to go, man. It's so much fornication in the mug, bro. But anyway, man. Yeah, to be... Oh, my God, bro. It says to be simple or in a sinister way to delude, allure. All right? Like, bro, I'm gonna tell y'all one testimony, bro. I seen a Mama Sita, man. Like, her face, bro, like I said, she was cool. And it's only because she had just like a shit ton of acne. But I'm not even tripping off that, because you can change that. But bro, when I saw her from behind, bro, I ain't a cat. I said, bro, I gotta tell her, man. I gotta tell her right now. I may not ever see her again. I'ma tell her right now. Bro, I literally walked behind this woman. And I said, hey, excuse me, can I tell you something? And she was like, hey, what's up? Like, no BS. And I said, you look amazing today, something like that. Bro, she like, when I told her she looked amazing, man, she smiled and like blushed and all kinds of shit, man. Like, bro, and when I tell you them yams was looking right, bro, she was looking right, bro. Her body was tight, man, okay? But I'm using that for an example because what? In Proverbs 16 and 24, pleasant words are as a honeycomb, man. It's not a sin to give a woman a compliment, bro. Sweet to the soul and health to the bones, bro. Alright, so shit, hey man, just like I told old girl when she was innocent, I said, look man, I may not see you again one day, but you know, I've been crushing on you since seventh grade, and I think you're amazing. That's what I told her, bro. Same thing happened, bro. Like, completely fell in love, man. Alright, that's why at the gym, bro, I'm trying to tell you, man, a lot of these ashas for you Israelites in the new covenant that's following the Lord, right? If you desire a wife, bro, a lot of these Ashas are single and they looking for beloveds. But the thing is, man, most of us are trying to first of all, be in a better position. Second of all, you know, we need to rely on Yahweh Shai to really show us, man, if that's the one for us, bro. And what's crazy, sometimes it may not happen the way you expected. You may be talking and all of a sudden, bro, you might come across a woman. She may know she's an Israelite or whatever. Next thing you know, you building up. Some of my beloveds, man, they found their ashas on debates. You know what I'm saying? And some beloveds got their ashas in the world. So it depends, man. Every brother's treasure is not gonna come the same way. Now, along the way, guess what? You're going to be like Joseph, bro. Meaning, if you're an Israelite male, you know, who take care of himself, man. Bro, you're going to have to turn down lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of booty, okay? Because the fear of the Lord, and then when you understand how deep love really is, we understand polygyny, but whoremongering and adultery, then you start to realize, like, oh shit, like, this is why the Lord said don't commit adultery. This is why you don't do it like that. But then your carnal or your flesh, you'll be like, damn, man, she a woman, bro. She acting submissive. She want to learn. So do I teach her? Like, do I rebuke her? Like, but these are things that Yahweh Shai gotta give you, man. You just gotta be in the spirit, honestly, because it's no specific way to really explain a scenario. Let's get Proverbs 14 and 15. This ain't nothing flowing in the spirit. This simple believeth every word, man. So clearly, when you look in this context, looking for a shawty, all right, a queen, right, a woman you want to walk in Yahweh Shai with, you can't believe every damn word she says, man. Not saying women are not stupid. I'm saying because you got a lot of Jezebels and bodies and minions, okay? That's just trying to use you for sex, man. Use it for your money. You can be a Israelite or a Gentile, okay? But the prudent man, a wise man, looketh well to his going, man. All right? So a wise man, when you're treasure hunting, you're going to check for your surroundings. Like, for me, bro, like, I like to go on their social media and look at what they like, you know what I'm saying, what they talk about, what they believe in, you know what I mean, Ask them the moral compass. And I ain't gonna cap, man. Like, the easiest way to really navigate, man, you gotta be the oddball out. Meaning, on those SYSBM videos I did about a year and a half ago, and I asked all those women, I said, hey, man, like, what you think about your virginity, man? And, hey, some of y'all saying, oh, they just tell me what you want to hear. But, bro, I mean, for them to even say that they take it very serious, it's still a win on my part, because at least I got them to say something contrary to the norm. All right, because one of the shawties, man, she said, no, you know, I take mine very serious. No, actually, most of them said that, man. I'm talking about a thick one, booty, snatch waist, chocolate. Okay, and she chill, man. I think that woman, I think two of them from Houston. Shout out to H-Town, man. But two of them from Houston, bro. And bro, you would have never. First of all, you would have never knew she was undefiled, at least sexually, because most dudes, oh man, she already had a man before me. Well, take it this way. If she's not contaminated sexually, bro, that's way more of a win than getting a scallywag. And this is important, because Paul and the disciples in the new covenant, even Yahweh Shai said, bro, don't let no man put us under. Because some of you guys don't think, oh, this ain't the gospel, because it ain't nothing deep. You ain't talking about the three woes. You ain't talking about the four kingdoms. You ain't talking about the parables. Bro, I've taught on all that, bro. Okay? But we have to touch on everything and every single aspect, man. Because brothers still got to live life, man. That's why in 16, a wise man feareth, man. You don't want to, you know, fall into the hands of a strange woman like Joseph did. He didn't do it, but he ran away. But King David, man, he saw Bathsheba, you know, probably saw her booty out and titties and everything, man. He got caught up in adultery, man. And it's not, and if now check this out, though. If this woman was single, according to the law of Moses, right, then he would have never committed adultery and departed from evil. That's why the scriptures say a man who committed adultery hath no understanding. They don't understand these things, man. But the fool rageth and is confident. Why do you think so many Gentile men and Israelite men, they think you gotta be you can't be a nice guy, you gotta be confident, you gotta be proud. And that's a false sense of masculinity, bro. That's why it says he that is soon angry dealeth foolishly. When you're dealing with a woman, especially, you can't snap all the time, bro. You gotta sit there like a sheep. Okay. And a man of wicked devices is hated, man. But let me get that Proverbs 5 and 24. Right. Proverbs 5. No, my bad. 21. For the ways of man are before the Lord, are before the eyes of the Lord Yahweh. So when you're already meditating on the commandments, you're already in the spirit, and he pondereth all his goings, man. So even the Lord pondereth your goings, man. See that? Because the scriptures say, matter of fact, let me get that, man, because I don't want to talk too much, bro. I know, and then some of you women that may watch this channel or may come across this video, you're probably thinking, like, this dude too loud, or he ain't hitting on nothing. But I had a Syrian woman on my other channel, bro. She talking about K Camp, you too loud. She said K Camp, the beloved, too loud, man. Hey, man, I'm completely innocent, bro. I don't even be out, beloved. But all praises to the Most High for creating help meets, man. Because really, in the orderly kingdom, dude, you know, we're gonna be in righteousness with the Lord, right, men and women. So that's what I'm meditating on, really. Let's get Psalms 119 and 133. Order my steps in thy word. And who is the word? Yahweh Shai, dude. Who is what? He comes in the volume of the book, man. The Lord never said, oh, I'm just create a woman for you beloveds to be single. Not the Lord. He wants us to enjoy it. And it's hard to think about that, because we be thinking, like, damn, like, how can something like sex be so holy? But that's what it is, bro. and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. Right? So when you're looking for a shawty, let not any iniquity, what's iniquity? Sin, have dominion over me. So you don't want to be constantly in adultery, man. It's hard because when you, bro, listen, man, for you women, y'all don't understand. Even though I know the cheat codes to some of y'all, to a lot of y'all, according to the scriptures, man, when y'all be having y'all buns out, I don't care how strong you are, man, sometimes it's just like, bro, why are y'all so goddamn beautiful? Like, why are y'all even shaped like that, bro? And it's too powerful sometimes. But that's why women know a man who can control his sexual urges is powerful. Why you think the loins and the scriptures go back to strength, man? But it's a beautiful dynamic thing of energy and spirit, bro. But I wanted to get another precept, and I'm gonna get Genesis 24 because matter of fact, hold up, dog, I got one. I got a perfect precept. Lamatazai, if you see this channel, please drop some jewels on the in the comment board. For any brother or sister, man. Because really, for the sisters, I want to do some lessons for y'all too. Because really, it go hand in hand. And these are for the beloveds in the faith. Because, man, 99% of people are not in the faith, man. Like, Yahweh Shai literally has opened up their mind. Let's get Proverbs 20 and 24, man. Man's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own way? Right? Sometimes, bro, you just be walking, man. You just be in your vibe, bro. And, bro, you could have... Bro, you could probably have a... Hold on, so I can... Bro, you can probably have a good old time, man. And a damn woman just come out of nowhere, bro. Just... The Lord just... Had her see you, man. Hey, shout out to my Aunt Gabar, bro. He was like, look, man. The shawties notice you before you even say a goddamn thing. Because of what? They're the weaker vessel. So they have to observe from a distance, man. Yeah, you women, bro. I be seeing you, bro. Because I be feeling the energy. Like yesterday, I was doing bench press, man. And I ain't gonna cap. Another mama sees it, bro. I think she's in the military, bro. But like, I love her, bro. The way she built, man. Like. Hopefully she ain't married. I never see her with a man, you know what I'm saying? But guess what? I would never know if I don't go talk to her. Alright? I saw her a couple... Listen for you, I can wait on the signals, man. A beloved might have to pull out the signals, bro. I might have to do a lesson on the signals, man. Because a lot of these... Most of you brothers already know this, but some of y'all who don't know, I might bring it out, but... Long story short, man, it was two Latinas, man. The one had stupid thick thighs, Popeye's chicken thighs in that month. And the other one, she was just fit. But she was thick fit. No, she wasn't thick, she was like a little bit less than thick, but she was still fit. I'm like, damn. And she got these glasses on, she looked all mature and shit. I'm like, damn, baby. Her hair on point, bro. I'm like, damn, even the chocolate, bro, I had a chocolate ebony, bro. Why are you women so goddamn? The Lord, bro, when he created women, bro, you gotta terribly just understand, but the Lord just be flexing, bro. Cause it was an ebony woman. I forgot about this one, y'all. She was fine to the mug too. But she was trying to, I guess, take down a bar off the rack. She was doing something with the bench, right? And let me tell y'all, I'm peep game. Women will like purposely, they will do shit on purpose just to get you in the area or try to allure you in. That's their way of enticing you, bro. Okay, she already got the work outfit on, beloved. Then she asking you to help, man. Like, bro, she literally inviting you in to have a convo. But low key, she told the beloved, she said, I'm sorry for bothering you. You know, I look kind of stupid. Bro, right when she said that shit. Right when she said that, K Camp was like, "Aw, shit, here we go again. Here we go again, beloved." Like, bro, I'm just in the gym, just lifting weights, bro. And this happened to a lot of brothers, but she said, "You know, I'm sorry for you know, bothering you, but I need some help, and I look kind of stupid. And guess what, bro? She had a strong accent, so I think I asked her, I said, do I hablar español? So I hit her with a curveball, like, bro, she ain't no okay, can't do some Spanish, you know what I'm saying? She ain't no okay, can't do a little bit of Spanish, bro. Hey, look, if you know a different language, man, that's another way of enticing, bro. That, how you think I got all of the, bro? I hit her with that, I said, yo soy 23 años, I'm 23 years old, bro. Bro, hey, listen, man, if you want a mamacita, man, if you want a shawty, like, if she's an Israelite from another tribe, bro, and you know another language, hey, man, you already, bro, you already in the game, bro. You done won the game. You done got 5 rings, bro. You straight, bro. You know, some beloveds can rap. Some beloveds can dance. Oh, I meant to say that, too, bro. The beautiful thing about getting your eyes shot, like somebody getting to know you, is when they really see what you're about. Like, bro, most women don't know K Camp can rap. Like, I can rap, I can kind of do a little bit of everything, but you gotta have the right type of godly woman to understand that. Like, my beloved Lamar Jazai, he rap, Kazaki rap. A lot of beloveds be rapping, singing. Ain't too many R&B beloveds, man, but. I mean, I didn't get the beloved number or whatever, but these are things to help build you up, man. I had another, I don't know if she was a white woman or whatever, man, but bro, I'm lifting the dumbbells, man, and she bending over in front of me, right in front of my penis, bro. I'm like, god damn, bro. And I had the gray sweats on, so obviously I'm like, dude, total thotty, bro. Not a shawty, man. And then I don't know, most likely she's an Edomite woman, but bro, I had like lots of snowflakes choose up on the beloved. Bro, got to the point to where the Ebonies was like getting mad. They were like, hey, Cam, what's your type? But they don't even understand, bro. Really in order, bro, Jake is just the daddy of the shawties, man. And the worst ones be like, they're, okay, this is what I found out too. When it come to Edomite chicks, the ones that's like acting racist and all that, bro, those be the main ones fantasizing, bro. But it's all wicked. It's just all just stupid shit. And that's seasonless, man. You ain't gotta act like that. But she talking about a beloved look like Jake from State Farm. Bro, her daughter in the car, and she talking about some, oh, you know, well, you're not gonna be single for long. Bro, women be, dude, they be totally marinating. Okay, and the wicked one, he can send a bad thotty shoot with a stupid whopper your way. She gonna throw it at you like a damn curveball. She gonna throw it at you like fucking them baseball players, man. Like she pitching in the damn game. Alright, she gonna throw it at you. Matter of fact, she might try to dunk it on your ass. Okay. Now some of y'all thinking you just overthinking, you just doing too much. Nah, bro. You know, my preference really, you know, isn't white women or whatever, but these are just testimonies, beloveds. Because, like, I be like Jacob. I be in my tent, man. But anyway, let's get an example. Genesis 24. I'm going to go to 37, right? Because some beloveds, and I'm speaking for myself, too, you know, I'm very reserved because I'm very, you know, observant. And most of the time, I'm really trying to invest in my health. Get my mental right first, and then obviously the scriptures. But so I ain't a lot, beloveds, man. Sometimes I be like, man, like I ain't on point. You know what I mean? I be like, I always try to be in an humble spirit. That way, I don't attract no scallywag, man. But even then, bro, like y'all know, being humble attracts more women. And then I've told a lot of these girls that I'm virgins, bro. I had an Assyrian chick straight up tell me. She said, look, I don't care if you're a virgin. I still want to have sex with you. Then the other one talking about she'll let me nut on her. I'm like, god damn, bro. Like, bro, honestly, bro, this is what I tried to do. I tried to say that to, like, get the strange woman away from me. But it, like, makes some of them, it makes them want to pounce on you even more. Then I got some talking about I'm a 9, I'm a 10, I'm a 8.5, I'm a 9. I'm like, bro, I just told y'all. I'm trying to follow the narrow, and then they came even harder, bro. All right. With Alma, Bro, she's stroking her necklace and shit. I'm like, damn, bro. Like, I thought y'all was supposed to be turned off. Like, what's going on, man? Like, bro, it was crazy. I thought that I was going to get roasted. Nah, bro. I've even had some tell me, nah, I don't believe that. I don't believe that. So, and really, make sure you have a positive energy, man. And a lot of that stuff comes from your diet, too. You know, if a woman, if she reject you, or maybe it's, if it don't go right, man, never lose your integrity or your personality, man. Always be yourself. Genesis 24 and 36. 37. And my master made me swear, saying, thou shalt not take a wife to my son of the daughters of the Canaanites, right, the African women in whose land I dwell, but thou shalt go unto my father's house and to my kindred and take a wife unto my son, man. Right? So, bro, he went to the beloved's house, man. He didn't just, you know, stay in the same place all the time. All right? Was crazy in 39, and I said unto my master, peradventure the woman would not follow me. And that's the spirit, bro, because sometimes we be like, bro, man, like, man, shawty too bad, bro, she ain't gonna follow me. I ain't gonna cap. I be thinking like that too, like, bro, ain't no way she gonna, you know what I mean, ain't no way she finna really be in the faith. But you just never know, bro. And like, it's harder as an adult, because you really gotta go out there and like look, because in school it was a lot easier because you saw the same people every damn day. You know what I'm saying? That's why the scriptures say get your wife in your youth, because it's way easier. I told my little guy brother that. But listen, and he said unto me, the Lord Yahweh, before whom I walk, will send his angel with thee, man. So the Lord, bro, he gonna send an angel, man, if you really laboring in his word. And my other I don't talk to him like that, but he told me, man, you know, he didn't have a car or a house or nothing, man. And his Asha begged him for like 3 years to come stay, bro. So really, that woman, shout out to all praises to the Most High, because that woman proved herself to him. So the brother got blessed, man. He didn't get married till probably, what, 28, 29 years old. You know, and he understood the polygyny thing. He understood, he knows about ITR, GMS, all that. See what I'm saying? But that's crazy though. And prosper thy way, and thou shalt take a wife for my son of my kindred and of my father's house, man. All right. So you're supposed to want them beautiful buns in her face, not just for her body, but just the complete package, man, and vice versa. That's why really, it's not a bad thing to really to think about that. What it is too, man, a lot of people are afraid to be hurt. And that's natural, because, you know, people out here shiesty and goddamn confused as hell. And then, beloved ones, you know, you got to get you a beloved that's willing to grow in the faith. Y'all got to read together. That's one thing I told one of my coworkers. She like 50 something, but she kept saying, go to the church, you know, get you a church woman. I was like, nah, because they the worst ones, and they going to be arguing. I said, they the worst ones, they going to be arguing. But honestly, bro, like, literally, what I gotta do, man, I gotta like just fast and pray more, man, and literally just go do what I'm supposed to do, man. And I feel like when you drive fast, you get closer to the Lord. And really, if you pray about it while you're fasting, I have faith that the Lord, he'll show you, you know what I'm saying, like your future destiny too. So let me see. Then, listen, verse 41. Then shall thou be clear from this my oath, when thou comest to my kindred, and if they give not thee one, thou shalt be clear from my oath, right? But that's crazy, because the beloved, you know, he was sent on his way. So first of all, when you look at this, I'm gonna go to 45. And before I had done speaking in my heart, your mind. Oh, bro, what? What am I seeing this? Am I seeing this, bro? Hold up, man. Bro, in 43, It says Genesis 24 and 43. Behold, I stand by the well of the water, and it shall come to pass that when the virgin cometh forth to draw water, and I say to her, give me, I pray thee, a little water of thy pitcher to drink. And she say to me, both drink thou, meaning both of us are going to drink, and I will also draw for thy camels. Let the same be the woman whom the Lord Yahweh hath appointed out for my master's son. Bro, that's... Bro, my beloveds, I'm happy, bro. This is... Look, when you if you got your scriptures on you, get Genesis 24 and 44, bro. No, 45, man. No, 44, yeah, 44. Dude, this proves my point when you're looking for an Asha, bro. Or some Ashas, bro. The Lord literally, it says, and she said to me, both drink thou, and I will also draw out thy camels. Let the same be the woman. So the Lord, the beloved, was using the angel, right? Or using the servant of Abraham. I got to read the context. But he knew the sign. It said, let the same be the woman whom the Lord Yahweh hath appointed out for my master's son. So Yahweh was giving beloved women, right? Okay, so it might take some time, bro, but you gotta be in the Lord. You gotta prosper your going, man. See that? Shout it. Okay. Wow. And before I had done speaking in my heart, right, in his mind, behold, Rebecca came forth with her pitcher on her shoulder, man. He knew that was the beloved. He knew that was Shawty, man. He knew that was his wifey. And that's an honorable title, man. Guess what? And because a lot of you people, man, you be thinking about 21st century pop culture logic. This is why you hate these type of lessons. But even for my repenting sisters, man, I mean, I'm pretty sure that the Lord could do the same thing with the husband. Read the book of Tobit. Brian, listen, man, it's a lot of baddies out here who's single, dude. And that's virgins on top of that, bro. Yeah, like, how do I know? Because I've had actual women tell me this, bro. I've talked to them in person, right? And I'm talking to you, Jakes, man, who, you're so against a man getting with a woman in these times. But again, you don't know the destiny of that person, you know what I mean? And on top of that, the Lord... You know, he'll send you a woman built for you. That's going to be willing to go through the afflictions. That's in Sirach 6. That's the easiest thing. That's the easiest test to go by. Sirach 6, man. Some of you jakes, man, she fine, bro. She tricked me. Okay. This is how you test a woman, bro. And be broke. With no car. Then some of y'all say, well, how that? I mean, that doesn't work either. Can't win with niggas, man. But anyway, and she went down unto the well and drew water, and I said unto her, let me drink, I pray thee. And she made haste and let down her pitcher from her shoulder and said, drink, and I will give thy camels drink also. So I drank, and she made the camels drink also. Now, hey, low key too, and on a high note, man, a woman may be feeling you too, but a lot of women don't understand, especially the unstable ones. Some beloveds, bro, we need gentle eye shots, okay? Cause yeah, women they'll shoot they shot, they will dunk on your ass, bro. Okay. And I ain't gonna cap, like, you know, hopefully the beloved ones get sweet tenderonies, man, because man, women can be very dangerous and deceitful too. They can be very tricky. Alright. But also, I don't want to waste her time and vice versa. And then what I also deal with too, bro, and this annoys the hell out of me, I'll have women just be like, oh, you know, any girl, we'd be lucky to have you. I'm like, bro, stop with the pop culture nonsense, man. And some of them, like, I had one, she told me that she was lusting after me. She wanted to, you know, have sex. She was in the truth too. And she was, you know, trying to rush to be with me, but we weren't even in the same city or whatever. But it didn't really feel right in the sense of some of them be wanting to cleave onto you so hard, they don't know how to let it happen naturally. They'll mess around and, you know, start playing with their vagina, and you know what I mean? Because, bro, it's terrible, man. This is why we gotta come back in the new covenant. But anyway, Genesis 24 and 47. And I'm bringing this out because, Jake, you gotta go out sometime and, you know, meet people. And I'm not talking about go to clubs and shit, or I ain't talking about that. I'm just talking about when you out and about, bro, you know, just kind of be in that Holy Spirit, but be on a hunt too. You might be at the grocery store, bro. You might see a woman there. She pretty, whatever. You may really take a liking to her. And make sure you actually like the beloved. Don't just approach a woman because she's beautiful, bro. Okay, that's part of it. But make sure you actually love the woman, man. Some of you dudes don't even be having feelings, man. Damn, blockheads. And I asked her and said, whose daughter are thou, man? Who is this shawty, man? Okay. Because you somebody daughter. And she said, the daughter of Bethuel, Nahor's son, whom Milcah bare unto him. And I put the earring upon her face and the bracelets upon her hand, man. So hold up, bro. The beloved decked the shawty out, bro. It says, and I put the earring upon her face and the bracelets upon her hands. Nah, Oxy trying to trick me. Bro, you guys gotta have some drip, man. Drip your girl like white, bro. She okay. Just like how Yahweh dripped out Israel as a nation. To what? Make them royalty. That should make you feel good, you know, if you're in a position to really, you know, flex on a woman like that. Not really flex on her like, you know, you the. Okay, fuck that. You got confidence. But some of you jakes be so militant and so camped out, man. You don't got no type of charisma. You don't got no desire for a wife. You just want to be around the brothers all day, man. You don't got no desire to get a mean cottage and serve the Lord. You don't got none of this stuff. Why? Okay. And so a lot of you, Jake, you don't want children or nothing, man. I ain't gonna cap, bro. I don't see how y'all do it. Unless the Lord literally got it like that, I don't see how y'all do that, bro. Because me, K-Camp, I am struggling. Okay? Also, don't get with the narcissistic, demonic type of woman. Because I ain't gonna lie, like, this girl on the screen right here, bro, she looks very demonic. And also, and you can read their spirit, man. Put it like that. That is one thing Yahweh Shai does give you. He, man, discernment level, bro. And I bowed down my head and worshiped the Lord Yahweh and blessed the Lord Yahweh, God of my master Abraham, which had led me in the right way to take my master's brother's daughter into his son. That's crazy, bro. We jump to verse 51. And behold, Rebekah is before thee, man. Take her, man. Take the princess, bro. Take your girl, man. Okay? Shout. Go take her to wife, bro. Virtuous woman. Godly woman, man. Okay? Well, I got a dress and a head wrap. How am I not godly? Bro, they were already wearing garments back then. Okay? They were already in their apparel. Like, this wasn't deep. And let her be thy master's son's wife. And according to the scriptures, you gotta have sex, man, to become one flesh, man. Okay, so listening to a love song is not, oh, you automatically fornicate. You automatically lusting. You religious people don't be understanding the context, man. As the Lord Yahweh has spoken. And I'm talking about these hypocrites, man. I'm not talking about people who believe. All right. Believe it or not, bro, women, listen, y'all can't fight it, bro. Even godly women, you do want to have sex, but y'all want it with a godly man, man. Alright, that's why everybody tripping and upset, man. That's why everybody got sexual frustration right now, bro. Everybody paranoid of each other because of these wicked minions in the world. This is why we have to fear the Lord. See that? Bro, oh my. And the servant brought forth jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment and gave them to Rebekah. He gave also to her brother and to her mother precious things. So that's what I always say, bro. You know, okay, why do you think these women are starting to realize what Jake like? You know, I'm talking about, you know, probably millennials to Gen Z, because the old head Jakes, you know, they want to shave their beard and they, I don't know, they weird as hell. But us, we like the women with the, some beloveds like the nose ring. Me personally, like I said, like the hoops. Some women be weren't rocking the shit out of hair wraps, bro. Now it's not a law, but I seen a chocolate ebony yesterday, bro. Stupid McChicken booty, bro. And but she was covered up and still had the McChicken McWhopper booty, bro. And she had some jewels on. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? So I see why Judah 10 and 19 said what it said. And on top of that, every day I go to work, bro. this Edomite dude, he had a whole family, bro. This dude swear up and down he can pull our sisters. He said, man, you know, this black chick back in Chicago. This bro, this nigga, holy. Bro, all women cold. And look, shout out to, listen, man, I've seen some super, super stupid fine Assyrian, bro. A lot of Assyrian chicks are Israelites too. When you read the book of Hosea, and I told them that, it's some, bro, you know, like I said, my preference isn't either my women, but bro, if you see Elisa Ann, bro, and she on point, that's a rarity, man. I ain't really hating on that. Some beloveds might, they might get a Moabite Ammonite. You never know. Moses had an Ethiopian woman, bro. So it all depends what the Lord wants for you, man. But 53 proves a point, because your woman, just like in Edges, you work, you go to war. They do all this stuff just to get a woman, bro. These street niggas, they killing over women. Like, do you know how powerful that is? And these creatures, the only way to really humble them is what? Fear the Lord and pipe them down, bro. That's the crazy, bro. This stuff is like too powerful, bro. All right. This is why Timothy said he would rather young women marry, man. And it's terrible out here, bro. Because there's so many adulterers. But I really think Genesis 24 and 56. And he said unto them, hinder me not, seeing the Lord Yahweh hath prospered my way. Send me away that I may go to my master, man. So when you go to, let me see, verse 60, and they blessed Rebecca, that was Jacob's mother. Her name is beautiful too. And said unto her, thou art our sister. Be thou the mother of thousands of millions, man. Procreative power, sexual prowess, okay? Being fruitful and multiplying. And let thy seed possess the gate of those which hate them. Clearly a foreshadow of Jacob, man. Clearly. And I think, bro, when you go to 65, for she said unto the servant, what man is this that walketh in the field to meet us, man? Alright, so the beloved, she peeped the beloved coming through. And the servant has said, it is my master. Therefore, she took a veil and covered herself, man. So these women obviously were totally different back then. But the point is, like, bro, they saw the beloved. And they had to make action, bro. You couldn't just stay stationary all the time and just suspect the Most High just to, you know, send you something. Sometimes you might have to go for a walk, bro. Or whatever you're doing. Right, like I said, I gotta read the context. I don't know, this gotta be Isaac, because that's Rebecca's husband. It gotta be Isaac. But anyway, and the servant told Isaac all things that he had done. Okay, and Isaac brought her into his mother Sarah's tent, and took Rebecca, and she became his wife. Man, he knocked down her dunies, man. That's according to the law. We just read it in Exodus in the Zondervan. It tells you sex consummates marriage. Again, microchimerism. When you skeet inside a woman, she retains your DNA. Okay? This is why in these last times, you know, a lot of these men and women are so contaminated because they don't understand what they're really doing. And they don't care to understand because they're a multitude. But, and he loved her, man. Now I said he just pumped and dumped. And he loved her. And Isaac was comforted after his mother's death, man. See that? So before Beloved even left the earth, man, they were trying to get Asha's, man. And Lord willing, I'm pretty sure, man, they in the resurrection with the Beloveds, bro. So that's a beautiful thing, man. All right, the Lord didn't just put a damn vagina and a penis on your body just to look at it, bro. All right. But those were, that was a good old little lesson, man. Going into for you Akim who may want a shawty, man, a wifey, virtuous woman. But again, the little things you can do, keep up yourself, man. You know, if you gotta lose weight, you know, dry fast. If you feel like you may not be up to par, like, bro, just do some research, man. Y'all gotta research things on how to upgrade your appearance, man. Sometimes, beloveds, bro, y'all can have any woman in the world, but sometimes, man, some brothers be funky as hell. Some of y'all just be dirty. Some brothers, for no reason. Am I talking ish? You know, my single brothers, you can make yourself appealing, man. And but first and foremost, like, you know, put salvation first. And put fear to your heart while you have a shot first. So with that being said, man, I hope that was edifying. Y'all boys be easy. Peace and blessings, inshallah.